Middle Path Radio, your number one online Islamic talk station.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين نبينا محمد صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد this lecture which is taking place in the 30th of ربيع الأول sorry in 30th of ربيع الثاني 1438 which is equivalent to 28th of January 2017. The title of this lecture is Introduction to Islamic Aqeedah. Introduction to Aqeedah. Okay, let me start and let me talk in an academic way and in a concise way. First of all, my dear sisters, or my dear brothers and sisters, many people misunderstand the word aqeedah and misunderstand the word Islamic aqeedah. And once they talk about Islamic aqeedah, or aqeedah, or creed, they immediately think of the different sects within Islam. And what is the correct sect? Is it Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah? Is it Ahl Sunnah? What about this sect? What about the Rafidah? What about the Khawarij? What about the Mu'tazila? How do we believe in the names and attributes of Allah Jalla wa Ala? Do we make ta'wil? Is it acceptable to make ta'wil or not to make ta'wil? And all these questions. And this is a misunderstanding of the Islamic Aqeedah. These are elements of Aqeedah that is true, but they are not the main elements of Aqeedah. They are not the main subjects that Islamic Aqeedah is trying to address. And hence, we really need to discuss the issue of Aqeedah in a very academic way, all the way from the beginning. Why? Because we don't want to end up in this wrong understanding. Okay, now this wrong understanding has so many negative consequences. One of them is the limited understanding of Aqeedah. Secondly, we might think about those who disagree with us in certain elements, such as how to believe in the names and attributes of Allah Jalla wa Ala, we might think that their Aqeedah is totally corrupted. In fact, we might think that they are disbelievers, or they have left the fold of Al-Islam. And that's why we have seen that there are so many misguided group, and most of these groups, or all these groups, they are calling other groups who differ with them in these elements of Aqeedah, they might call them as kuffar, as disbelievers, as if they have left the fold of Al-Islam. And the issue of takfir emerged as well. And then the consequences of takfir found a good space within the Islamic debate or within the Islamic theology. One key thing, or one key reason behind this, is the misunderstanding of Aqeedah or Islamic Aqeedah. What do we mean by Islamic Aqeedah? Okay, this is one thing. The other thing, this limited understanding of Aqeedah led to the fact that some people who think of themselves as if they were on the correct Aqeedah, because they don't do ta'wil of the asma or and sifat, the names and attributes of Allah Jalla wa Ala, they don't think that they have followed misguided sects in these matters. They think that they are the safest sect, and they think that they are on the truth, while they have misunderstood main concepts of Aqeedah. While in fact, they were misguided in some main concepts of Aqeedah, which might take them out of the fold of Al-Islam, although they might think that they are on the absolute truth. Okay? And this is called, as the scholars called it, al-jahl al-murakkab, compound ignorance, where you don't know and you don't think that you don't know. Okay, and I will give examples about such people. So I wanted to say that some people think that they are on the absolute truth, but they are actually misguided. Why? Because they missed the priorities in terms of the Aqeedah, and they mixed between the main concepts of Aqeedah and the furu' of Aqeedah, the very branches, the very small branches of Aqeedah. Okay? I don't want to discuss now at the moment what are the usul of Aqeedah, or whether there are usul of Aqeedah or not. Okay, but I will discuss that. So there are so many negative consequences based on the misunderstanding of the reality of Aqeedah. Okay, again, there are so many negative consequences that are built on this misunderstanding of the correct Aqeedah. Okay. So let us start, as I said, right from the beginning. Once we talk about Aqeedah, what do we mean by Aqeedah? What do we mean by Aqeedah? Normally, to be honest with you, brothers and sisters, I like to hear from people, what do we mean by Aqeedah? Okay? And it should be actually given a space, given some time to discuss what is Aqeedah and to see how people perceive the word Aqeedah or understand the word Aqeedah. However, just because of time limitations and because of logistical issues, let us go into it directly, although I don't believe that this is the right way to get into it directly. Okay, now once we talk about Aqeedah, we need to understand that I do not talk about the Islamic Aqeedah. No, Aqeedah in general. Okay, what is Aqeedah in general? Obviously, as a Muslim, I have my own Aqeedah. The atheist has his own Aqeedah. The Christian has his own Aqeedah. The Jewish person has his own Aqeedah. And maybe the Buddhist and others. And now we have other types of Aqeedah, such as secularism. Okay, it is Aqeedah. Nationalism is another form of a new Aqeedah, okay, and so on. So what do we mean once we say Aqeedah? What do we mean by Aqeedah? Okay, Aqeedah or creed or belief or faith, okay, whatever word you use, I don't want to get into the nitty-gritties regarding the differences between those terms, faith, creed, theology, belief, and so on. No, let us talk about creed in general, Aqeedah in general, what a person believes in, okay, belief, okay. So, what do we mean by that? See, Aqeedah is the answer for the fundamental questions that every single human being would like to know the answers for. Okay? Again, Aqeedah is the answer or the answers, the collection of answers of the basic questions that every single human being would ask, would like to know their answers. This is Aqeedah. Okay, now someone might say to me, what is your proof for that? Okay, first of all, the word Aqeedah, if we go again in a very technical way, Aqeedah means what the person is believing in terms of what he or she, what they believe strongly on, in a way that they have tied their hearts on. And the word Aqeedah comes from عقدة. عقدة means عقدة, means tight, strong. Okay? So the concepts that you have tied your heart on, okay, is Aqeedah. Now, every single human being, and again, once we talk about what is the dalil on this, the word aqeedah is not a word that came in Quran and Sunnah explicitly, and that should have a definition given by Quran and Sunnah. No, it is a word the scholars used in order to explain what the person believes in, okay? What he or she tightened their hearts on. Okay, so every human being has certain questions that he or she would like to know the answers for. They are always asking these questions. They are sometimes struggling to come up with these questions. What are those questions? Again, once we discuss this topic, normally we would like to hear from people, okay? And that is the best way actually to tackle this subject. But again, because of time and other logistical issues, let me get into that. See, once we say, once we talk about these questions, every human being would like to know who created him. Where did he come from? Okay? And if he is created, what is the relationship between him and his creator? He would like to know who he is. Okay? Who am I? What do I need to do? What is my purpose of existence? Okay, what is, and then these are the fundamental questions. Yeah, who am I? Who created me? What is my relationship with this creator? Why I am there? Why I am here? What is the purpose of my life? What is next? What will happen to me? Once I die, where am I going to go? These are the fundamental questions. And once the person knows these questions or knows the answers for these questions, he will move to another set. Okay? Which is, what is, how did this God, or what did he want from me? This creator. What did he, or what does he want from me? Why did he create me? How does he communicate the message or what he wants from me? How did he communicate that with me, okay, or with other human beings? How is he going to judge me? And then, what is my relationship with others? What does the Creator want from the entire humanity? This is another set of questions. Maybe, of course, these questions, as you can see, these are like framework, or they build a framework of questions rather than the exact questions that everyone would ask. But these are the main questions anyone or everyone would like to know the answers for. Okay? And then another set will come through, which is, how do I need to conduct my life? How do I please this creator? What happened before? What will happen later? Does the creator want all of us to worship him? Does the creator want the entire humanity to obey him? Am I free in choosing what I want to do? What are the consequences of what I want to do? What are the consequences of my decisions? This is another set. Now, I hope that this is clear, sisters. Now, if you see, if you have written those questions and you look at them again, you will see that, well, it is true. Any human being would like to know the answers of these questions. Okay? And see, one of the consequences or the negative consequences of misunderstanding what Aqeedah is the fact that we see many of our youth, young Muslims, are confused. And, you know, atheism now is on rise within number of Muslim communities. Why is this? Because they were not taught the correct Aqeedah. They were taught that Aqeedah is to believe in the names and attributes of Allah Jalla wa Ala without ta'wil, without tahrif, without tashbih, etc., etc. Okay? They were taught that, okay, Allah Jalla wa Ala sent prophets, these are the prophets. They were taught that qada'a qadar, okay, that everything happens, okay, by the qadar of Allah Jalla wa Ala. But they were not told what is, or they were not taught about what led to these answers. Okay? They were not taught what is called the wisdom behind this Aqeedah. They were not taught about the principles on which these answers were built on. Okay, I hope that it is clear. So that's why if we want to discuss Aqeedah, we should start discussing it all the way from the beginning. And subhanallah, my dear brothers and sisters, if we read the Quran, we will see that the Quran is answering or is providing answers for these questions. Especially, my dear sisters, if you look at the Makki Quran. The Makki Quran is the Quran that was revealed in the beginning of the da'wah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. What was the main topic, or what were the main themes or topics of the Makki Quran, the Quran that was revealed in the Meccan period? We see that it focuses on the purpose of life. It focuses on the greatness of Allah Jalla wa Ala. It focuses on the Akhirah. Okay, and we will mention some of the ayat. It focuses, it provides answers for those questions that we have mentioned. Okay, and Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, the wife of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who was a scholar, who was a faqih, who was a siddiqa, she told us this clearly. She said, the first verses to be revealed, the first Quran to be revealed, was the Quran that talks about Allah and the hereafter, the Jannah and Nar. And once people endorsed Islam, okay, which means فَلَمَّا فَاءَ النَّاسُ إِلَى الْإِسْلَامِ, once Islam penetrated the hearts and minds and souls of people, then those ayat that started to speak about halal and haram were revealed, which means that the Aqeedah is the answers for these fundamental questions that any human being would ask. Okay? Again, who am I? Who created me? What does he want from me? Where am I going to go? What is the purpose of this life? How God or the Creator communicated his message with other people. How does he communicate his message, which is what he wants from me with me? Okay, these questions. Okay, let us go to the Makki Quran. Among the Makki Quran, yeah, we read the first surah that was revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق خلق الإنسان من علق اقرأ وربك الأكرم الذي علم بالقلم علم الإنسان ما لم يعلم. These are the first ayat. Okay? That speak that the first ayat that were revealed to explain to humanity what aqeedah is. Okay? What aqeedah is? Iqra. O Muhammad, read, recite. Recite the Quran, which will be the source for all these answers. Okay, then someone might ask, why do I need to believe in this Quran? Why do I need to believe it? Yes, because it is اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق. It was revealed by your Lord, the one who created. Okay, he created human beings from علق in these different stages. Okay, اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق خلق الإنسان من علق اقرأ وربك الأكرم. Read. Okay, and your Lord is the most honored, the greatest. So now these ayat are introducing the concept of who? The concept of what? The concept of creation, the concept of created beings, the concept of creator. And it introduces to us that everything comes from the creator. Okay? He is your Lord. He is our Lord. We need to do things for him, and we need to take things from him. We need to take how we view the world, how we view ourselves, how we get to what is right and what is wrong. We take everything from him. Allah lahu al-khalq wal-amr. Okay, this is an example. Sorry, this is how the Quran introduced Aqeedah to us. Okay, let us go and read other Makki surahs. Whether, and as you know, that the entire of Juzu Amma, the last Juzu of Amma, is a Makki Quran. Okay, a Makki Quran, except Surah Lam Yakun Alladhina Kafaru Min Ahli Al-Kitab Wal-Mushrikeen. But the rest is a Makki Quran. If you study that juzu of the Quran, either from Surah Amma, according to the order of the Mus'haf, or you study it according it was revealed. Okay, you will see that the Quran is focusing on what? On providing those answers. Okay, after Surah Iqra, if we say that Surah Al-Muddathir, okay, without getting into which surah was revealed immediately, but among the first surahs to be revealed in the Quran, Surah Iqra, okay, Surah Al-Muzzammil, Surah Al-Muddathir, Surah Al-Duha, okay. So, for example, Surah Al-Muddathir. What Allah Jalla wa'ala says in the beginning of Surah Al-Muddathir, Ya ayyuha al-muddathir, qum fa'anzir, wa rabbaka fakabbir, wa thiyabaka fatahhir, wa rujja fahjur, wa la tamnun tastakthir, wa li rabbika fasbir, fa'idha nuqira fil naqur, fadhalika yawma idhi yawmun asir, ala al-kafirina ghayru yasir. Oh, al-muddathir is the one who is wrapping himself. Allah Jalla Ala is commanding him to go and stand and warn people, to pass the message to people. Okay, the message, which message? The message that was introduced before, which is اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق. Devout yourself for your Lord, the one who created you. Okay, why? Because the da'wah is one of the very important obligations. At least da'wah, not to the details of Islam, but to the to provide the main answers for these fundamental questions for the entire humanity. This is what Allah Jalla wa Ala wanted the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam to do. Okay? قُمْ فَأَنذِرْ. Stand up. Okay? Don't sleep. Okay. And warn people. And وَرَبَّكَ فَكَبِّرْ. Glorify your Lord. وَثِيَابَكَ فَطَهِرْ. Purify yourself. Because the deen of Islam is a deen of purity. Okay, and then
one question.
Okay, and then just a minute, please. فإذا نقر في الناقور فذلك يومئذ يوم عسير على الكافرين غير يسير. Subhanallah, it introduces what? It introduces the concept of the hereafter. And also, it introduces the concept of kafirin. Means there are people who will disbelieve in what you have saying, O Muhammad. And those people are kafirin. They rejected the truth. And hence, they will face the consequences of that. In fact, in Surah Iqra itself, Allah Jalla wa Ala mentioned at the end of the surah, the adab of those who go against the commandments of Allah Jalla wa Ala. Whether we say that the end of Surah Iqra was revealed, okay, with the surah itself, or was revealed in a later stage, but it is a fact that it is a Makki surah, among the first surahs to be revealed. In that surah, Allah Jalla وعلى says كلا إن الإنسان لا يطغى أن رآه استغنى. Yeah, this is a very important concept. Oh human being, don't transgress, don't go, don't think that you are self-sufficient. Okay, don't become arrogant because you feel that you don't need others. No, you need Allah Jalla وعلا. You are the created being of Allah Jalla وعلا. And Allah Jalla Ala condemned this kind of arrogance that some human being have. كَلَّا إِنَّ الْإِنسَانَ لَيَطْغَى أَرْرَعَاهُ اسْتَغْنَى. Then at the end of the surah, Allah Jalla Ala warned those who are going to deny these facts. Okay? The fact that they are created by the Creator, He is their Lord, He is their Supreme Being, He is the Supreme Being. They need to do everything for Him. They don't need to have arrogance against the commandments of Allah Jalla Ala. Now, I can go on and on talking about this, but inshallah, this yani gives you a snapshot of what we are talking about. However, I know that many of you will ask a fundamental question here. Okay? Which is, but those ayat did not tell us who Allah is. Who is the Creator? Did not have a discussion, a rational discussion, about the existence of Allah. Maybe someone might say, listen carefully, someone might say that, but the Quran or these ayat that you mentioned, whether Surah Iqra, or Surah Al-Muddathir, or Al-Muzzammil, or other surahs, they did not they did not prove the existence of God, which is the very basic element of Aqeedah. You just said that the Aqeedah is the set of answers for the fundamental questions. And the fundamental question should be, does God exist? And my dear brothers and sisters, please listen carefully. This is not the fundamental question. This is not the fundamental question. Again, this is not the fundamental question. This is, in fact, a fake question. That's why you see that it was not discussed in the Quran thoroughly. It was discussed, okay, at a later stage. Yeah, not in the beginning, at a later stage, and again briefly, such as the beginning of Surah Al-Anbiya, such as the beginning of Surah Al-Furqan. Okay, تبارك الذي نزل الفرقان على عبده ليكون للعالمين نذيرا. Or أحسب الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا آمنا وهم لا يفتنون. These chapters, Allah جل وعلا briefly mentioned, okay, this issue. أم خلقوا من غير شيء أم هم الخالقون أم خلقوا السماوات والأرض بل لا يوقنون. Yeah. Again, we have a limited time. Otherwise, we can go through number of ayat that discusses this issue. Okay. So أم خلقوا من غير شيء أم هم الخالقون. Were they created from nothing, or have they created themselves, or have they created heavens and earth? Yeah, this is a rational proof. Also, Allah جل وعلا says, لو كان فيهما آلهة إلا الله لفسدتا. Had there been more than one ilah in these heavens and earth, then there will be corruption and fasad and mischief on this earth. Okay, which means Allah جل وعلا is saying, rationally speaking, there should be one ilah alone. Okay, now, my dear sisters, someone might say, well, this needs more clarification. Again, more clarification. My dear sisters, this question, which is, does God exist? As I told you, is not a real question, is a fake question. Why is this? Why is this? Why do you claim that this is a fake question? Because every single human being is born believing in the answer of this question. Every single human being is born or was born believing that there is a creator for him, there is a supreme being above him or her, whether he is called Allah or not, but it is embedded in our hearts, in our minds, in our souls. It is created with us. That's why the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam said, كل مولود يولد على الفطرة. Every single human being is born upon fitra. What is this fitra? What is this fitra? The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam carried on and said, فَأَبَوَاهُ يُهَوِّدَانِهِ أَوْ يُنَصِّرَانِهِ أَوْ يُمَجِّسَانِهِ. His parents will make him a Jew, his parents will make him a Christian, or his parents will make him a Magian. What does that mean? The Prophet ﷺ didn't say that his parents will make him a Muslim, which means that every single human being, whether he is born next to Kaaba, or whether he is born in New York, or whether he is or she is born in South Africa, in China, in Alaska, in Brazil, with those tribes. Okay, every single human being is born believing that there is a Lord, there is a supreme being. This is the minimum of fitrah. And Allah Jalla wa Ala confirmed this in Surah Al-A'raf. Allah Jalla wa Ala says, وَإِذْ أَخَذَ رَبُّكَ مِنْ بَنِي آدَمَ مِنْ ظُهُورِهِمْ ذُرِّيَّتَهُمْ وَأَشْهَدَهُمْ عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ أَلَسْتُ بِرَبِّكُمْ قَالُوا بَلَىٰ شَهِدْنَا أَن تَقُولُوا يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ إِنَّا كُنَّا عَنْ هَذَا غَافِلِينَ. Allah Jalla wa Ala says, and mention to them, O Muhammad, or tell them, inform them, that Allah Jalla wa Ala, okay, created them in the past, and He created in them believing in Him, and He asked them, yes, wa ashhadahum ala anfusihim, He asked them, who am I? Yes, wa ashhadahum ala anfusihim, alastu bi rabbikum, not just who am I, no, am I your Lord? And they said, shahidina, we testified that you are our Lord. That's why even scientists now, they say that if there is a human being who lives in the desert, he's not influenced by any external ideology or any external theology or any external influence. He or she, they will look at the heavens. They want something from this supreme being. Okay? And subhanallah, my dear brothers and sisters, the ayah that we have read, okay, أَمْ خُلِقُوا مِنْ غَيْرِ شَيْءٍ أَمْ هُمُ الْخَالِقُونَ أَمْ خَلَقُوا السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ بَلْ لَا يُوقِنُونَ. Allah Jalla wa Ala said, they do not believe, but they are disbelievers. No, the disbeliever, he is denying the internal yaqeen, the internal certainty that Allah Jalla wa Ala created in him or in her. That's why Allah Jalla wa Ala, when he sent Musa alayhi salam, okay, and the story is mentioned in details in Surah Al-A'raf, in one of the discussions. Musa alayhi salam came to Fir'aun. Fir'aun, he used to say that I am your supreme Lord. Yeah, أَنَا رَبُّكُمُ الْأَعْلَى. And he was denying the existence of God. He said, مَا عَلِمْتُ لَكُمْ مِنْ إِلَهٍ غَيْرِي. I don't know of any other God for you. Okay? What did Musa alayhi salam say to him in the beginning? طيب, when Allah Jalla wa Ala mentioned in, this in Surah Al-A'raf, قال ففررت منكم لما خفتكم فوهب لي ربي حكما وجعلني من المرسلين وتلك نعمة تمن علي أن عبدت بني إسرائيل. قال فرعون وما رب العالمين, وما رب العالمين. فرعون out of arrogance, he said وما, who or what, sorry, not what, not who, okay, because if he says to, if he says who, then it means that he believes in God. But out of arrogance, he is claiming that there is no God. So that's why he said, وَمَا, and what is رَبُّ الْعَالَمِينَ. What was the answer of Musa alayhi salam? Look, this is an example. The Quran is mentioning this is to tell us about this principle of fitra, that all human beings born believing in fitra. Okay. Musa alayhi salam said to him, قَالَ رَبُّ السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ وَمَا بَيْنَهُمَا إِن كُنْتُم مُوقِنِينَ. He is the Lord of heavens and earth, and what is, and what is ever between heavens and earth. إِن كُنْتُم مُوقِنِينَ, if you are what? Muqineen, believing in certainty. But they are not believing. No, 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 no. If you do not want to deny what you believe in, okay, then you will realize what I am saying, that Allah is the Allah, the one whom I am calling you to believe in, is the Lord of heavens and earth. But because you are denying that, so you don't want to believe in me. What does that mean? Musa alayhi salam did not have a debate or a rational argument with Fir'aun, the most tyrant, the one who denied the existence of God. And you can say atheism, he is like the father of atheism. Yeah? What? How Musa addressed him? He said, no. What you are saying, okay, is not true. If you believe internally and you do not cover your belief, your internal belief, you will realize that Allah is the Lord of heavens and earth and what is between them. Subhanallah. Look at this. Okay, I can talk about this more and more, but again, it is a hot subject, I know, but we don't have time to dwell into it more. So, the Quran, my dear sisters, provides us with those answers related to what is the purpose of our existence? What is the relationship between us and the Creator? What does He want from us? Where are we going to go? Yes? What will be the consequences of obeying God and the consequences of disobeying God? These questions, okay, are the very basic questions of Aqeedah. And then the Quran starts to talk to us about what Allah wants from us. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنَّ وَالْإِنسَ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ I created jinn and ins for one purpose, to worship me. Allah Jalla Ala also said in a Makki surah. Yes, in a Makki surah, Allah Jalla wa Ala says in a Makki surah, in surah al-insan, هل أتى على الإنسان حين من الدهر لم يكن شيئا مذكورا إنا خلقنا الإنسان من نطفة أمشاج نبتليه فجعلناه سميعا بصيرا. We created the human being from a sperm in order to test him. To test him means what? Whether he is going to worship me or not. And Allah Jalla wa'ala said to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sahbihi wa sallam, O Muhammad, say to them, قُلِ اللَّهَ أَعْبُدُ مُخْلِصًا لَهُ دِينِي. Okay? Say to them, I worship my Lord, Allah Jalla wa'ala, alone, sincerely to Allah Jalla Ala. So the Quran now provided us with this answer that we need to worship Allah Jalla wa Ala alone. Then the Quran told us, okay, clearly that people will be divided into the people of hell and the people of hellfire and the people of paradise. Allah Jalla wa Ala introduce the day of resurrection to us again in the Makki Quran. عما يتساءلون عن النبأ العظيم الذي هم فيه مختلفون كلا سيعلمون ثم كلا سيعلمون ألم نجعل الأرض مهادا والجبال أوتادا وخلقناكم أزواجا وجعلنا نومكم سباتا وجعلنا الليل لباسا وجعلنا نهار معاشا. See, in this surah, Allah Jalla wa'ala is saying, oh, they are asking about an-naba' al-azim, the great news. What is an-naba' al-azim? An-naba' al-azim is the day of resurrection. They are asking about it. So Allah Jalla wa Ala said, haven't they seen the creation around them? What will happen, the night, the days, etc., etc.? And then Allah Jalla wa Ala said, inna yawm al-fasli kana miqata. This is the day of resurrection, where we will separate between the people of hellfire and the people of Jannah. Okay? That is Yawm al-Fasl, the day of separation. Inna Yawm al-Fasl kana miqata, yawma yunfakhu fi suri fata'tuna afwaja wa futihat as-sama'u fa kanat abwaba wa suyirat al-jibalu fa kanat saraba inna jahannama kanat mirsada. So Allah Jalla wa Ala introduced, what is this day? The day of resurrection. Then Allah Jalla wa Ala said that Jahannam, in brief, because of time, Jahannam kanat mirsad, it will be the punishment of the disbelievers. Then Allah Jalla wa Ala said, إِنَّ لِلْمُتَّقِينَ مَفَازَ حَدَائِقَ وَأَعْنَابَ وَكَوَاعِبَ أَتْرَابَ etc. The muttaqeen, they will have, that they will be rewarded in Jannah. And Allah Jalla wa Ala mentioned some of the types of the reward in Jannah. Subhanallah, this theme, we find it throughout the Makki Qur'an, which means that Allah Jalla Ala is giving us the answers for these fundamental questions. Who am I? Where am I going to go? You are the slave of your Creator. Your Creator is the greatest Lord. Is the greatest supreme being, is the supreme being, is the only one who created. No one else created other than him. You have to worship him. If you worship him, you will be admitted to paradise. If you do not worship him, you will be admitted to, if you do not worship him, you will be admitted to hellfire. And then Allah Jalla wa Ala, after that, okay, introduce the principle of risala, okay, like in surah, what is mentioned in surah al-anbiya and what is mentioned in surah Nuh and in other surahs, that Allah Jalla Ala sent number of prophets, all of them, as Allah Jalla Ala said in surah al-anbiya, wama arsalna min qablika min rasulin illa nuhi ilayhi annahu la ilaha illa ana fa'budun. We have sent every single prophet before you with one message, that there is no God but Allah, and worship him. Okay? So the concept of prophethood. And then, okay, the other articles of faith, sorry, within that, not then, the other articles of faith were explained, okay, with more of introduction who Allah is, talking about the names and attributes of Allah Jalla wa Ala. Yes, that Allah, He is Ar-Rahman, He is Ar-Rahim, He is Al-Malik, He is Al-Quddus, He is the one to be glorified the most. سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى. سبح, سبح means what? Glorify. Okay, glorify your Lord. He is Al-A'la, the highest. He is the one who created. Everything goes back to him. And then, okay, we see that Allah Jalla wa Ala spoke about his names and attributes, such as قُلْ هُوَ اللَّهُ أَحَدٌ اللَّهُ الصَّمَدُ لَمْ يَلِدْ وَلَمْ يُولَدْ وَلَمْ يَكُنْ لَهُ كُفُوًا أَحَدٌ. Okay? And then, as we said, Allah Jalla wa Ala introduced the principle of the malaika, the angels, the qadr, okay, and the kutub, the other articles of faith, believing in Allah, okay, believing in, we spoke about it, but the other articles of faith after believing in Allah, sorry, the other articles of faith were introduced within that, okay, within these verses of the Quran, these chapters of the Quran, within this introduction. They believe in the books of Allah Jalla wa Ala, the prophets of Allah Jalla wa Ala, okay, the angels of Allah Jalla wa Ala, and then believing in the divine decree, al-qada wal-qadr, and believing in the day of resurrection. Allah Jalla wa Ala introduced all these articles, which we call them articles of faith, that were mentioned in Hadith Jibreel alayhi salam, the very famous hadith, أن تؤمن بالله وملائكته وكتبه ورسله واليوم الآخر وأن تؤمن بالقدر خيره وشره. Okay, so this set of beliefs constitute the basic principles of Aqeedah. Again, what are they? I am a human being. I am a created being. I have one job, which is to worship my Lord, who is the supreme being, Allah. He is the greatest, Al-Ali Al-Azim. If I worship him according to what he wants, he will admit me to paradise. Otherwise, I will go to hellfire. Those who were arrogant and they do not want to submit to him, they will be admitted into they will be admitted to hellfire. They will be punished because Allah will be angry with them. How do I worship my God? I worship my God according to the message that he sent to his final prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. I worship him, okay? I devote the entire life. قُلْ إِنَّ صَلَاتِي وَنُسُكِي وَمَحْيَايَ وَمَمَاتِي لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ. To him, Jalla wa Ala, everything is in my life is an act of ibadah. I worship him according to the message that he sent to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The message that he sent to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is of two types, the Quran and the Sunnah. Who is Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the final messenger. Which means that Allah sent a number of messengers. Which with each messenger or with most of these messengers, Allah jalla wa ala sent books. Such as the Torah, the Injil, and the Zabur. Okay? And I believe that everything, Allah Jalla wa Ala controls everything. Allah Jalla wa Ala sees everything. Allah Jalla wa Ala decreed everything. I believe in the divine decree, in the qada wa qadr. Okay? And Allah Jalla wa Ala created angels. Those angels they do whatever Allah Jalla wa Ala commanded them to do. لا يعصون الله ما أمرهم ويفعلون ما يؤمرون. And finally, the day of resurrection is meant as a day for accountability. Allah Jalla wa Ala will hold every single one accountable for whatever he or she did. Those who obeyed him, they will be admitted to paradise. Those who do not obey him, they will not be admitted to paradise. They will go to hellfire. Finally, this means that the deen of Islam is the only truth and the ultimate truth. The deen of Allah Jalla wa Ala is the only truth, the ultimate truth. And it is the best set of instructions and guidelines that we should live by. Because the meaning of worshipping Allah Jalla wa Ala, as we said, it means that we submit completely to Allah Jalla wa Ala. We worship him in every single minute of our life. And not only that, because Allah Jalla wa Ala becomes so angry with those who do not listen to him, Allah Jalla wa Ala commanded us to take this light, the light of Islam, the light of Al-Quran, he commanded us to take it to the entire humanity. We are commanded to pass this message to the entire humanity. These are the main principles of the Islamic Aqeedah. And I hope that I have clarified that to you, my dear sisters. Jazakumullahu khairan. If you have a question, then please do ask.